Guys, welcome to BNG TV. I'm Basila Shapadra, and today we're here with Cece Coco, who is a dancer. I'm sure you guys have seen her work, her Instagram. Your Instagram is popping. But she's shy, by the way. She told me she's shy, and I'm like, you're a dancer. How can you technically be shy?
I'm really shy.
How? Why? Why are you shy? You've done interviews before, right?
Yeah.
Do I make you? Is it because it's BNG? Like, are you shy? Why are you shy?
No, I'm a shy girl in general. Like.
Okay. Yeah. So how did you come up with this stage name, Cece Coco? Because I know you're not going to tell us your real name.
Alright. Basically. My cousin, my older cousin, gave me that name.
Okay. Yeah.
It's like. You know in French, when you say Cece, it means good.
Okay, I don't know that. I guess people are realising that now.
Cece, so he tried to mix it, and then Coco means like, it's a sweet name for girls.
Okay, yeah,
so Cece Coco, because like, when I dance, is that sweet?
When she dances, is that sweet? I love that. Okay, so for people who don't have Instagram, how old are you? Just for people who are on YouTube.
Well, I'm only 21.
Okay. She just turned 21, by the way. So how was that? Because we did see your big birthday celebration and everything.
It was good. It was great.
Okay, what country are you from, for people who don't know?
Well, I'm from Ivory Coast, but I'm born in France.
Okay, so, you know, as we go on, you're definitely going to teach me some French. I hope you know that.
Like, definitely.
Be ready for that, because we heard you on the phone. You need to teach us some of that. Okay, so, as we know you're a dancer, when did you begin dancing?
Well, I've always been dancing, but I took my dancing serious when, like, because I was proper ill.
Okay.
I got ill, like, and I literally died.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, so I was in the hospital
for like 6 months. I hope you're okay now.
Yeah, I'm fine now. Mm-hmm. And then from there, when I started dancing, when I started dancing again and people started to like my videos, then I thought, why not take it serious? So from there, that's when I took my dancing serious.
Okay, so what inspires you to carry on dancing and not stop and make it a profession?
Because I had to learn how to walk again.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So I guess when you think about where you were then and where you are now, it probably inspires you to just carry on doing more. Oh wow, okay. So I feel like we first recognised you when you were dancing for Afrobeat, you were one of his dancers. How did that opportunity come up?
Basically, when I started getting bait on Insta, Afro asked me to be his dancer, but I was already dancing for NDNC.
Okay.
Yeah, I was NDNC's dancer. Then after that, like, it didn't really work out with them.
Okay. So would you tell us what happened with them, or are you disclosed? You signed a disclosure, you can't.
Oh, basically, with NDNC, it was a thing where they were taking my talent for granted.
Okay.
Like, they wouldn't want to pay me.
Oh, okay.
So they were like, oh, we're giving you an opportunity, but it wasn't that deep.
Yeah.
They needed me more than
okay.
I needed them. But then they did help me out as well with links and stuff, But yeah, I just decided to go my own way, and that's when I decided to dance for
Afrobeat. Yeah. Okay, so when you were dancing with Afrobeat, we realised you were obviously, it wasn't just you, it was you and someone else.
Yeah.
So were you guys friends before, or did you meet as that opportunity came along?
No, basically, me and Francine have been friends for years.
Okay.
Yeah, like, she's been in this game before me.
Okay.
Yes, like, remember when Azunto was the...
Yeah, that's what started everything.
She was a dancer then, and then when I decided to take my dancing serious, then, like, sometimes if she gets booking for two... She'll bring me in and stuff. So I think so. Yeah, and then me and her was friends anyways.
Yeah.
And then after she met Miracle.
Okay. Is that Miracle? No? She a dancer.
Yeah, she was four of us as well.
Oh really? There was three of you.
Yeah.
Oh.
Dancing for Afrobeat.
Oh really? I thought it was just two of you.
No,
I didn't know.
It was her and Miracle first, and then after it was, and then Miracle left, then it was me and Nana.
So how did you guys deal with the negative comments you guys would get? Because I remember a lot of people, let's be real, a lot of people will always say, Cece's the better one, this is that. How did you guys deal with that? And did it disrupt the friendship?
Well, I think they got used to it after a while.
Look, what, she got used to it after a while, got used to hearing that?
Yeah.
Do you believe you're better at dancing than her?
I don't think so. We don't really dance the same.
Okay, so... Why, because we all know you guys, you're solo now. Why are you guys not together anymore? Why don't you dance with her anymore?
That question.
she knew I was gonna ask this one.
Me and Nana are better when we're not a group.
Okay.
Because in this dance industry, people like to make dancers compete.
Okay,
and it's not a good thing. You see how everyone used to say Sis is the best and that.
Yeah.
That's what brings competition in dancers. And like even on Instagram, like when you see everyone posting videos and then they'll be like, oh yeah, but Sissy does it more.
Yeah.
That fans as well can give people
it's
big
true.
Like no, it's basically with Nana, she's a nice girl, but jealousy came between us.
Oh, okay.
I'm not gonna lie.
Okay.
I have to say it today.
I feel like we all realise that anyway.
Jealousy.
Even if you don't say it, I feel like everyone kind of knew that.
Yeah.
Because it was like that. Everyone was, I feel like you were the more popular one.
And like things that, like rumours and stuff, like hearing that she's telling people she made me and stuff. And I was thinking, okay, made me, but I'll always be grateful to this girl, because at the end of the day, when I didn't know anyone in London, when I first came to London, I was staying at my sister, but she was like, oh, come to my house.
Okay.
So we was together, like, even our first video together, Kelly, what, well, I don't know if you
guys know.
We danced together and everything. She was nice. She made me confident in front of the camera.
Okay.
That's one thing I can say she done for me, but made me never.
She's like, never. So you believe it's better to be on your own?
Yeah, it's better, because she's a good dancer.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a good dancer as well, but in with together, it doesn't
mix.
Work. But we still dance for the same artist. We still dance for FB.
Yeah.
But we're not a group.
Okay, so I would say, because a lot of people were saying, because I did see a post of yours recently where you wrote this long paragraph on to those who are saying made me, like, we figured you were talking about Afro B.
No.
Because a lot of people were saying, okay, we won't know her if she wasn't dancing for Afro B. So how would you take them comments?
People that don't know, stop assuming. Especially on Instagram, people get deceived a lot. I will never say that to Afrobeat. I'm still Afrobeat's dancer, and I would not deny that.
That's amazing.
But the only reason why I put that on Instagram is because recently me and Nana had a lot of beef going on, and a lot of people came back to me to say how she's telling everyone I'm ungrateful because she's made me, because I used to stay at hers. But it's really not that
don't deep. Don't brag about people.
I will never say anything about Afrobeat, like, no way. Like, me and Afrobeat always talk and everything. Even the whole story, the whole drama that's going on right now is on my side right now, because obviously he knows what's been going on, he knows the real story.
Yeah.
So for her to go around and talk rubbish,
It's a bit mad. So what advice would you give people who are, because there's so many groups out there, so many
and dancers.
There's so many dancers, like, and I'm sure every now and then they'll have their disputes, they'll have their arguments.
Yeah.
What advice would you give them? Like, how do you reckon they should stick together? All
I think dancers should stick together. It doesn't matter if you've got more followers or more likes than each, like, than someone else. We all love one thing, and it's dancing. So we should, like, support each other and everything. Even if you feel someone is not humble or anything, you don't need to talk about it. You don't need to gossip about it, or, like, even caption on Instagram can mean a lot. I don't know, a lot of people like to judge people over Instagram pictures or followers.
It's true.
When it's really not that deep.
I understand. Okay, so this is the bit everyone wants to know. When it comes to romances, like, that's when people tune in. So, and we know you're already smiling, so we know you have a guy there.
Mm-hmm.
How would you say you balance a busy schedule and a relationship?
Well, he's my manager, so.
Oh, jeez. Well, them Nicki Minaj situations then, like.
Yeah, he manages
me. Would you reckon that's good, though? Because, God forbid, something happens, is that still going to be your manager?
Yeah, because he's really mature.
Okay.
He's mature. Like, when it comes to business, he's mature. He's not them guys, like, yay. He's not getting too like, and he's not a jealous guy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, my ex before him.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about, we know about your ex,
yeah, he was a dancer himself, but then him, because I blew, like, I got bigger, not bigger, oh my God.
This guy's going to be watching this, you don't want to put yourself
in
it.
No, because I got bigger before him now, he got jealous of me, so our relationship went down.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we fixed our problems now, everything is fine. Mm. But now with this boy, my boyfriend now, mm-hmm. what my ex didn't give me, he's giving me everything. Okay. Like, he supports me, he's always there for me and everything.
This is a very important question. Okay, so yeah. Did you guys meet, did it start off as business, or was there a rope, like, was he your manager and then you fell in love, or did you fall in love and say, okay, be my manager?
Well, me, I don't really mix business and pleasure.
Oh, so it was...
We was together then.
Oh, okay, then you just thought...
Yeah.
Okay, I understand that. All right, since we all know, guys, she's taken, she's not... like, don't DM her. Okay, let's get into your dancing. Let's get back into dancing. Yeah. So we saw that you'll be doing the Afrobeat uni tour. How did that opportunity come about?
Oh, yeah, basically, the man that's doing... the whole thing mm-hmm. used to be my manager.
Okay. How many managers have you had?
I had three.
Oh, what's?
I mean, two and three. Yeah, he's my third one.
Okay. So he brought that opportunity.
Yeah, he brought me to join. Yeah.
Okay then. So we've seen that your dance classes are very popular. Like, do you think you're the person who started this whole dance class thing? Because even now, I think your ex-partner, she has a dance class now.
Yeah.
Like, did she... You're just throwing all the shade. I don't ever have to do anything, right? Yeah. So what, did she... do you reckon she copied you, or, like, did you both talk about the idea?
Basically, when I started my dance class, yeah. Well, I think Chevy Silver started her own dance class before all of us started. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Because I went away to Portugal for a booking. Mm-hmm. Then when I came back, that's when we decided to do my dance class. Okay, yeah. So I was like, okay, because no, I'm not really confident. So like,
it's so weird when you say stuff like this, because I feel like you're such a good dancer. Congrats on your performance mm-hmm. at the UEFA 2016. How was that? How did that opportunity come about?
They emailed me.
Okay.
Yeah, because they wanted me to come and represent UK there.
Okay.
It was like a big dance thing, like a battle.
Yeah.
You had to represent battle. your country. Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. That's top the yard. Yeah. That is funny. Okay, so how was doing the stage and how was the crowd on that? Like, how's crowd response like? How'd you get the crowd?
It was good because I didn't know I was actually known in France.
That's sick.
Yes, yeah, so it was good. Like, I met a few people mm-hmm. and stuff, but then, yeah, it was fine.
That's great. So, what's been your biggest collab so far? Like, would you say it's Mr. Easy?
Well, my recent.
Yeah, video. Your recent. Would you say that's the biggest person you've worked with?
No.
Who's the biggest person you've worked with?
I don't know who's bigger between Pato Rankin and Davido.
Ah. Oh, I'll say Davido.
Oh, yeah. Then Davido.
Oh, really? Okay, that's dope. How was it working with him? Like, is he friendly? Like,
well, the only time we spoke is when we said hi, and the director was going to be the main dancer for the night. Yeah.
Okay.
That's it.
And is that how all the kind of bookings are? You don't really get to meet the artists. You just...
Yeah, well, I had the chance, but I had to rehearse and everything. Okay, and it was everywhere. And everyone was taking pictures with him. Okay, and that's when he had this segue, so he was on his segue all night.
Segue times. Okay, so have your family members always supported your craft?
Yeah.
Has it been from the start they've supported? Have you ever had, like, anyone who's not so supportive? And have you lost any friends in this journey?
Yeah. I have lost a friend in this journey, and my family, my dad, well, all my family support me, literally.
Okay.
Yeah, because my dad used to manage big artists in France. He's mm-hmm. there, he's a manager. He manages French artists, so he wanted to manage me, but
nah. You would rather have your boyfriend. Have a boyfriend. Instead of your dad.
No, my dad said my boyfriend should manage me, to be honest.
Okay. So. Whenever we talk about this boyfriend, big smile. Like, I love it. Okay. Did you enjoy being the main girl in BM's video?
What video was that? Yeah, because that's my type of song. I like fast songs.
Yeah, because your waist just...
Yeah.
Moves a bit. Okay, so what's been your most embarrassing experience? Like, have you ever danced? This is what I fear of dancing, like dancing on stage and just...
Yeah. You get a lot of males trying to get with you in your DMs, even though you have videos of you and your boyfriend, yeah, you and your... So what message would you send out to them?
Just actually, like, I really don't.
Boys don't really message me.
They don't. Because they think a lot of boys message me.
Yes,
because
they won't message
me. So they're like, well, no. Okay. Yes, I don't really get
it. I don't really need, anyway.
No.
I don't really need boys messaging you. Okay. So what advice would you give to another young person wanting to become a dancer or wanting to have their own dance school, as you said?
Well, to work hard. Don't listen to what people have to say. Because I remember when I first started, everyone was out. Even till now, people are saying I'm boring now. I only move my waist and stuff.
Yeah.
But on Instagram, I'm not gonna lie, I do repeat my moves because it's just Instagram.
Okay, so you just say.
So don't listen to what people have to say.
Do
your thing and follow your dream, literally.
Okay.
And so if your family supports you, then don't look back.
Amen to that. So where can people find you on social media? We know your Instagram's popping, but let's have your Instagram name, your Snapchat name, so they can know, add you up.
Yeah, my Instagram name is official_CC_Coco.
Yeah.
And my Snapchat is CC_Coco.
Okay, cool. So now it's time for you to teach me how to dance. The beginning of your social media dance journey, I'd say. We saw you were dancing with a girl you referred to as your twin.
Yeah.
So what's the story with her like, and what was it dancing duos with her?
Oh, basically we started together.
Yeah.
Cause me and her actually dance the same.
Okay.
So that's what we called each other, twins. Yeah, and then obviously when I moved to London.
I love her, she's confident and you're shy with this. It's crazy, but I love the way you portray yourself though. So you just started your own dance class.
Because I'm not really confident, and Nana knew that, so she was like, oh right, let me do your warm-ups every Friday.
Okay.
Then I was like, okay, no problem, because me myself, like, because obviously, I knew people would come and stuff, so I needed someone by my side.
So
we started together and everything. Then, from there, she decided to do her own dance class. Then I was like, okay. But
you went back to okay.
The way she left my dance class, I wasn't really happy about it.
How did she leave?
Basically, one day, because we talk to each other every day. Like, one day she came to my dance class late. She didn't tell me. I don't know if you know that bitch Afro UK TV.
Yeah,
he came to my dance class with some of his dancers.
Okay.
So he came now and he wanted me, you know what she's doing now, he wanted me to do that every Tuesday and Thursday.
Okay.
But I couldn't. But so when she came in now, late, very late, and then I was teaching so I didn't have time to say hi. So I'm done now, said hi to her. I was like, oh, you don't look well. She said she's not well, that's why she's late. I was like, okay, no problem. My dance class is done, but she got up to teach Jason's kids, students.
During your dance class?
No, when my dance class was done, but in the same
situation.
Then I left, I came back, they're still there. Then I didn't say nothing. Didn't message her nothing. The following week, I'm at the bus stop going to my dance class, and I see her coming to her dance class. Then I was like,
how orcs?
Then from there, everyone messaging me, blah, 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 her dance class. I was like, so bad. Obviously, she's been in this game for a long time. If she wants to do her dance class, it's a good thing, but it would have been better if she came to me.
Yeah.
Came to me and told me, well, I'm doing my dance class, we could have supported each other.
Yeah.
But she made it. And people don't know that, and they think I'm the one
At least you know, at least you've explained everything. I'm sure after this, everyone will understand, honestly. That's why it's great you came in here. Okay, so let's get out of this mix-up beef. Do you have any other talents other than dancing? Like, can you draw, can you act, can you sing? Is it just dancing?
Well, I used to sing at church.
Oh my gosh, that's good!
Yeah.
Why are you shy? You need to solve this shy stuff. Okay.
I used to sing at church, yeah. I'm alright at singing. Not the best, but
okay, that's good. So, anything outside the media, like can you write, or you like what else do you think? Because let's say everyone has talent, honestly. Only talents that you don't know. Like honestly. So do you think you're going to dance forever? Like
No.
Don't you enjoy it?
Like,
is it not something?
But I do, but it's not a thing. When I'll be 25, I will not be dancing. Like, no way. It's so not my dream to be a dancer all my life.
So what would you be doing then? Do you reckon you'd be settled enough? And
probably, that's how I see myself. Like, obviously, I want to open my own dance academy. Yeah. So like, after, because right now I'm still learning how to teach and stuff. So when I'm ready, I'll open my own studio where people can come and, you know.
Yeah.
So I want to be known as the best Afrobeat choreographer.
Amen. Mm-hmm. No, because people have been here teaching before and I've never got it. So maybe you might be a person to just make me look like I can dance, because I need something simple. And also, that's what I want to ask you, because I get irritated quickly. Like, if you're in your studio, when you're teaching someone and they don't, you know, some people are quite slow, how do you deal with that?
I got used to it, so like,
so I just takes have to be nice. Yeah. I remember my mum telling me I could never be a teacher because I'm just like, so you just have to learn to be nice.
Yeah.
Alright, cool, so you're going to teach me something simple now.
Alright. So first thing is 1, 2, 3, and 4, yeah? Then from there,
you
tap, tap.
I said easy, I thought it was easy, but I didn't think it was easy.
Okay, so if I'm 4,
yeah,
4, then 1, 2, 2, 1, yeah,
okay,
that's it.
Shall wait, I thought the first bit, wait, go on.
Okay, first bit is this. 1, 2, 3, 4, down, down, up,
okay,
yeah?
Shall we start with the song?
Yeah.